Holy Asgard, that's a lot of SD cards. A1, UHS-1, Speed Grade 3, High Endurance. How could someone possibly know which of these is best for their drone, dash cam, or Android? Not to worry, friends. I got you. Hello, everyone, and welcome to DIY in 5. I'm Trisha Hirschberger, and today we're talking about all the different types of memory. Not episodic, short-term, or autobiographical. No, this is a tech show, dang nabbit, and we're talking how to go about choosing the optimal memory for your Android device, dashcam, or drone. There's so many options, which can seem really overwhelming, but really, it's better for you and your device to get just the right type. If the tips in today's video got your drone flying, then give this video a like and hit that subscribe button so you don't miss out on any future tips. Secure digital or SD cards come in two main form factors, SD and micro SD. Mini SD used to be a thing, but no one's made them since 2008, so they're pretty much dead now. In a quest to get tinier and tinier, most devices use micro SDs, but a lot of micro SDs come with a full-sized SD adapter just in case you need to go back and forth between the two formats, like this one from Kingston. For the purposes of this video and keeping it simple, I'm using the term micro SD to refer to the various speed and capacity specifications that we've seen in recent years. Micro SDHC and micro SDXC specifically. And we'll just call them all micro SD. Now, micro SDs can hold up to 1 terabyte of storage. Crazy. But there are times when bigger is not always better. If you lose it, break it, the dog eats it. These are just a few examples of why it might not be the best choice. Plus, you'll be paying a heftier price tag to keep it all on one card. Kingston makes cards up to 512 gigabyte capacity, which is still way more than I usually need for 99% of situations. Now, for my fellow Android smartphone-wielding friends, one of the best parts about being Team Android is that we often get to boast about expandable storage. Just pop in a micro SD and we're good to go. But what kind is best? Look for a little A1 or A2 marking on the card and you'll be set. This stands for App Performance Class 1 and 2, meaning the card is fast enough to be used on a mobile phone by apps in addition to media storage. Kingston's Canvas React micro SD card makes use of this A1 classification and is available from 32 gigabytes up to 512 gigabytes, but your phone may not support larger capacity cards, so be aware of that. For dash cam users, you'll want something that can record over and over again with little to no issue, so high endurance cards are where it's at. As video files are overwritten, the memory card wears down bit by bit. Certain cards are more durable and meant to work in these specific circumstances. Kingston has a high endurance micro SD that can record 3 times that of a normal micro SD. Make sure you look for a card specifically rated for endurance and bonus points if it comes with a warranty just in case. Now, for my drone pilot friends, there's no single standard just for you, unfortunately, so we'll have to dig a bit deeper. Obviously, different drones will require different minimums, but as an example, DJI asks for, quote, up to 128 gigabytes and read and write speed up to UHS 1 speed grade 3 on their latest models. UHS refers to one of 3 ultra-high speed classifications in addition to the speed grade of 3. Now, this sounds complicated for sure, but to make it simple, Kingston's Canvas Go and Canvas React cards have you covered. Just look for the little IU with the number 3 in the U on the card. So that's SD cards in a nutshell for Android, dash cams, and drones. What other use cases would you like to hear SD cards broken down for? Let us know in the comments and maybe we'll make a future episode just for you. It's like I'm your personal shopper for tech. Is that a job? I think I'd be really good at that job. Anywho, make sure to subscribe to the channel and tap the bell so you know when we have a new upload, and I will see you next time with more DIY in 5.